what? Let's just try to jump off these hooks. All right? Okay. On your mark, get set, jump!
Entertainment Tonight presents...
One, two, three, four,
Laverne and Shirley,
six,
together
seven, eight,
again.
Schlemiel, Schlemazel, Hobson's Incorporated.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Schlemiel, Schlemazel, Hobson's Benford Incorporated.
Tonight, be a part of television history, starring Penny Marshall and Cindy Williams. 20 years ago, you loved them as two blue-collar workers from Milwaukee. Now they're having fun playing Laverne and Shirley all over again.
Do it our way. Nothing's gonna turn us back now.
The Laverne and Shirley family reunites to share their personal stories, their favorite moments from the show, and the rare bloopers that didn't make it on the air. Television events you won't want to miss with special guests David L. Lander, Michael McKeon, The Big Ragu, Eddie Mecca, and Betty Garrett. From Paramount Studios, the original home of Laverne and Shirley, please welcome Penny Marshall and Cindy Williams.
Long time since we've been on the Paramount line.
Yes,
together.
20 years.
20 years.
Yes.
Two decades.
This is not the stage that we shot Laverne and Shirley on. That would be stage 20.
And this is stage 29.
Yes.
But they did try to make a facsimile of our living room in Milwaukee, right here, and they gave it a shot.
Point out that one of the real things on this set is Boo Boo Kitty. What we used to do when we started the show is we'd come out actually before the show and we'd ask the audience if they had any questions for us. So we'd like to do that right now.
We'll be happy to answer them if you just let us sit down.
Yes, because these shoes are killing me.
Her shoes are killing me.
I wore my handmade custom spangled sneakers. See? Here.
How did the idea for Laverne drinking milk and Pepsi come about?
I drank milk and Pepsi. That's what I drank growing up.
Because
my mother sent me to kosher camp. We're not Jewish, but we went to kosher camp because they had better food. But they don't drink milk with meat. So when I'd come home, I'd say, why do I ever can't have soda? Why do I have to drink milk?
So she wound up mixing it half and half.
And it took the out of the milk, you know, when you drink milk, and the out of the Pepsi. And so I drank it. And many people have gagged at my house watching me do this. I'm sure people will have that reaction, but that's what I drink, and I still swear by it.
You two still friends today?
No.
We're the kind of friends who we might not see each other for years and years, but when we do see each other, it's like 8 seconds has passed.
Did Laverne and Shirley ever win an Emmy?
We didn't exist in the industry. We just existed with the public.
We got a Bottle Cappers Award.
And Teamster Award.
Yeah, Teamster Award.
See, the critics really didn't like our show. They didn't say the nicest things about us.
Yeah, they called it slapstick.
Don't just stand there! Do something! You know what you're getting up on! You're getting up!
Everybody I can in the building.
Please, it's
Do either of you have a favorite episode that you, special memories filming?
I like Murder on the Moose Jaw Express, which was a two-parter. I like the guinea pig show, which
when we were lab rats.
Yeah, to make enough money to go to this swanky party, Laverne was sleep deprived, and I went without food for 2 whole days.
What is your favorite show?
I like the fireman show.
Look, what I'm trying to say is, will you?
Yeah.
Will you?
That's Ted Danson before he became a big star on Cheers.
Oh, gee, I'm getting a bad case of the monkey nerves, Cheryl. Like,
no,
feeling.
No, no.
I also like the Army episode where I was afraid to jump out of a plane.
All right, okay, all right, calm down. Calm down. Come on.
We pretty much like any episode where we got to do physical comedy.
Carry her around.
Very strong. A lot of times we didn't make it through these.
Yeah, we made mistakes.
Things are very hot. Last night, right after...
Not so well, eh?
No, not so well.
Come on, let's go explore and check out the guys on board. I want him to be near a cute one when we go through a bridge.
No, you don't.
A tunnel.
Try it again.
Okay, all right, we'll be right there. Okay, bye.
Does Bobby want to see me?
No, that wasn't Barbie. Okay, all right, we'll be right there. Bye-bye.
Does Bobby want to see me?
No, that wasn't Bobby.
Who was it?
Don't do that to me.
Sometimes we just made each other laugh.
Laverne and Shirley together again. The return of Lenny and Squiggy.
But you know what? Once the door opens, the magic starts. You'll be fine. I think I'm going to throw up, though.
Laverne and Shirley together again. We'll be right back. Welcome back as Entertainment Tonight presents Laverne and Shirley together again.
They gave us little hats.
Those are two other members of our cast that were never nominated for Emmys.
And they dearly deserved them.
Yes, they did. I mean, they're wonderfully talented guys. We're talking about Lenny and Squiggy, Michael McKean, and David L. Landon.
Kissing's over.
Right.
Hello.
That was never my line. That was always,
always David's line.
I was practicing it backstage.
Go ahead, try one more.
Hello.
No. You're making too much of it. No, easy, easy. Let it roll off. All right, we'll get to you. We're going to see some other people.
You never wanted to say it. Remember the fight about
it? Yeah. Say it.
But how did it begin?
I said only one hello a show.
Laverne, there are some people in this world you just don't.
Hello. Hello. Hello.
Howdy, duties.
West across.
We're like Romeo and Juliet.
But first, I have one question. Which one of us do you think is prettier?
Well, maybe if you ladies are a little bit short of cash,
you
could find it in your hearts to repay us in other ways.
Oh, God.
Tall, skinny guy. He was good.
What happened to him? Okay. We'll take some questions.
Yeah.
We'll give some answers.
Questions for Michael and David.
Did any of you date in real life?
Anyone?
Well,
did we date anyone or each other?
It's
so sad.
David and I dated.
I got some of my more interesting hate mail when word came out that I was dating Cindy.
Yes, and we had a not being there too shock.
That's right.
Michael and I had to stand together so they could stand together for their family album.
It's wonderful when two people you really like get together, but in this case, we couldn't wait for it to end.
Yeah.
This person here has been holding up his hand.
Oh, yes, sir.
What would Lenny and Squiggy be doing in the year 2002?
Probably working for Enron.
Yeah.
But they would have gotten in the last couple of weeks, though. Just keep showing up at the office.
It's an opportunity. Oh,
yeah. All these phones, nobody's using them.
Don't go away.
I thought it was really natural.
Coming up, the rare bloopers just discovered from the Laverne and Shirley vault.
Well, I didn't pick up the wrong thing, guys.
Coming up next.
Seen rotten when Elmer Fudd made Daffy Duck eat that dynamite.
Hey, will you shut up over there? We're trying to watch the Lenny and...
professional or anything, but those are the only two times I remember
perfect.
Yes.
Oh, you screwed hours, up plenty.
Hours and hours of rehearsal were skipped routinely.
And yeah, sometimes things would go wrong, but thank goodness they didn't film them.
I know, my little sugar tart. But first, we...
Well, what do you say we go down to the Goodwill drop?
Yeah, we can check.
Where these people go, I don't know. Well, what do you say, the two of us go down?
So now it's the two of us.
Hey!
Here's more good news. You and Shirley can get married now.
My little sugar tart. But first, we must come up with a plan.
A good plan. There are many mysteries for us to unravel.
Mystery number one.
Little sugar tart. But first, we must come up with a plan. I think he stuck his tongue in my mouth.
Oh, yeah.
We'll talk about that on the
air. So much time, we had nothing to talk about.
Speaking of which,
oh, don't you start.
There were lots of animals on the show.
And why was that?
Cindy
no,
has
I
a
like
thing.
Animals. Cindy has a thing for animals.
She hello. Oh, sorry, I thought that was my
name. It's so natural. It just works perfectly.
I come back.
She does. She belongs to a lot of animal organizations, which is very lovely.
Mm. I'm not against animals. Trust me. It's working with them that I'm against.
We had a...
And we had a show about a German shepherd and his trainer...
In order to get him to growl on cue.
...had to wear a yellow slicker and run out in front of the audience and go, fritzy, fritzy, fritzy. It would make me growl.
Laverne, this is my friend Fritzy. Come here and pet him. Come on. Come on.
Hi, doggy. How you doing, doggy?
To meet guys, huh?
Yeah. Carmine and Edna reunited. Plus, Penny's real-life fall on the set. Stay tuned for more of the funny twosome together again.
It's Laverne and Shirley try to remember.
Next.
He was a famous trumpet man from out of Chicago way. He had a boogie style that no one else could play. He was the top man in his craft. He was gone with the draft. He's in the army now, a blowing reveille.
going to blame me.
I blame you because you made me dance.
Yes,
and I
did.
Didn't dance, and you danced because your mother
was a tap dancing teacher in the basement of our building in the Bronx.
That's right. And you danced. And
I had to learn how to tap dance.
But you assumed the entire world could
yes,
tap
dance. Yes, I did. That's how I am. If I could do it, I feel anyone can do it. Used in every number, I think. But she did very well for someone who hadn't had much training. But we needed some professional help.
Some people from the musical comedy world.
Some people
world.
Who knew how
right.
to do it.
Eddie Mecca and Betty Garrett, who were
yeah.
from New York. I was out here for 3 days. I got Laverne and Shirley. And when I auditioned for Laverne and Shirley, they didn't even know I could sing and dance. They just thought I was a funny actor. I fooled them. But then they found out I could dance. I got to work with one of the great MGM musical stars, Miss Betty Garrett. I got to do a big dance number with her. Good evening, huh? Good evening. Let's have a good evening. Okay, all right.
Ladies can do that.
Yeah,
I'm a Yankee Doodle Dandy. Yankee Doodle Doo or Die.
I'll tell you the truth. We're out of vermouth, but there's plenty of gin.
Oh, no. Now, read my lips. No. You're gonna hug and kiss me and expect me to drive all over the state of Wisconsin. No way, no. I'll go see if I got enough gas.
You did a lot of physical humor. Did anybody ever get hurt?
You have a story about when you fell. You were trying to feminize me.
That's right.
Feminize me. Yes. Not like Martinizing, but feminize me for Jay Leno.
Penny's supposed to shove me off the edge of the couch, and in my mind, I wanted to do a fall where I just fell. I didn't move. I kept my legs crossed and just fell and went boom on my butt like that. And didn't work out quite that way.
I must admit, Laverne, I've never seen this side of you before. I kind of like it. Hey, Cheryl, why don't you split?
What? And leave Laverne unchaperoned? Oh, no. Excuse me. I must have nodded off.
But that was the first time I ever felt a pain in my back, was that moment when I fell there. I went, ooh, something's gone forever. And it was.
The big one, the biggest fall I took was I was in a astronaut. They were testing an astronaut suit. And all week I had rehearsed with no helmet, no anything. And I was on wires, swung from the ceiling. And so this is the scene as it was shown.
Hey, what are you trying to drop? You're trying something. What are you doing, John? John!
waiting for you.
Stop it! Whatever needs to do it.
Luckily, in a scene like that, since I'm covered so much, we would shoot it at the dress rehearsal, at the early show for audience. Because at the nighttime performance, from having spun, well, you'll see what happened in front of the audience at night.
Yeah.
And you fell off a couch.
Yeah, I know. Well, the sympathy card, we play it again.
My back's a little screwy. So the cast, I called the cast together. I said, okay, don't touch this side of my body. If you touch my head, you could touch my knees. Because there's another scene in the living room that took place. And everyone knew how to touch this, keep away from this.
Sounds like my honeymoon. You can touch this, don't touch this.
Well, that's how I felt. But you did well. You touched my head a lot,
right,
my knee, and
life.
We went on with the show.
There's more still to come. Would Penny and Cindy ever be Laverne and Shirley again? Find out next.
If you notice that it's only one shot going in by men pushing this bed up and down. You know. Now, pull! Get off! Get on top of her! All in one take in front of the audience, and that was what, you know, how we did the show.
Well, you girls should do that kind of comedy today. I mean, you can still do that.
No, we
physical
can't.
Stuff.
I'm a grandmother. I'm a grandma. I have a 9-year-old grandson.
Neither here nor there. I can imagine Laverne and Shirley on one of these amazing fear of survival type reality shows.
No, I don't think Shirley would go on one of those shows where they make you eat monkey droppings.
Well, we might, because we'd probably be living together and still broke.
Hurry up, Laverne. We don't want to be late for the Island of Doom audition.
I'm right behind you. Shirley, I can't stop thinking about the $1 million.
Ooh! All right, guys, clear the stage for the extra competitors. Who's auditioning next?
Two divorced locals. They came here by bus.
And where are they? Where are they?
We're here! We're here!
You know we came in the wrong door.
And whose fault is that? These helpers make us look fat.
There they are.
Oh, look. Here. You're beautiful.
Oh, hold it for me. Hold it. I asked you to hold it.
I couldn't hear you.
Well, you can't hear anything. Then you...
Step to the red marks, please, and tell us something about yourselves.
Red marks.
Yeah, we're there. Go.
Hello, my name is Shirley Feeney Meany, and if I could just take this opportunity to tell you what a thrill it is for us to be here. We are huge fans of Island of Doom, and last season we wept when Carlos was dragged off and eaten by the dingo.
He wept.
See, anyway, I'm the mother of three children, and if I am lucky enough to win the $1 million, I will tie the portion to the Feral Kitten Rescue League.
Enough already!
Let's hear from the one with the L.
Okay, my name is Laverne DeFazio, Caracciola, O'Brien, Weinstock, Roosevelt. Three wonderful children and two you'd just like to give a good slap to. I work as a security guard at the Bradley Center in Milwaukee, where I get to frisk people, which I enjoy very much. Go Bucks! Go. Peace out.
Okay, you'll be given a set of three challenges to be completed in 5 minutes. Proceed to the little tiki and receive your first task.
I'm starting the clock.
Got it.
Read it. What does it say? What does it say? Quickly. Give me that. Give me that.
Oh, great, great. We're going to be the first contestants disqualified because we can't even read the clue.
To the left, ladies. To the three giant heads of Motu.
In
one of these mouths there lies treasure. In one of these mouths there lies pleasure.
Mouth and pleasure, I'm doing this one.
But in one gaping hole lies a horrible troll and a fate too disgusting to measure.
Girl, I don't want nothing disgusting to happen to me.
Laverne, come here. Come here, man. Come here. Now, Laverne, I've known you my entire life, right? What disgusting thing could they possibly do to you that has not already been done by scores of hockey players and firemen?
They are our national heroes, Cheryl.
Well, I know that, and I don't need them.
Ladies, please, this is hyphen, hyphen. Once inside that head, you must stay there until the mad parrot squawks.
Parrot?
Pick a hole now.
Which hole?
Hole number two. Just get in. Hole number two. Go. Go.
My goodness.
Oh, my goodness, sir. Sir. Oh, my goodness, sir. This man is eating my friend. Oh,
Feeny, I'm sorry. Please, oh, thank you.
Mrs. Feeny, Meeny, did you hear a parrot squawk?
You're going to be disqualified.
Get Mrs. Hyphen Hyphen back in the hole.
This isn't the good licking. Oh, please, Cheryl.
Just a few more seconds.
Someone's touching me.
Please,
they're touching me. Ow! In the wrong place, Cheryl.
Now go to Umbuto's box of bugs and eat one whole insect.
No, no, I can't do that.
Oh, sure. All you had to do was stick your head in hole number two.
Don't you ever mention hole number two.
Oh, Laverne, please. Please, Laverne, I cannot do this. I can't. They're God's little creatures. You do it. Please, please.
No, this is so easy. It's going to be like taking a little... Holy mother of bugs.
I can't do it.
Cheryl, I was in a hole. You're going to eat a bug.
I can't do that.
Do it.
No, no, I can't do that. I can't do it. No, I can't.
Yes, you can. Yes, you can. Think of the $1 million, Cheryl. How about all those kitties you're going to save at the refuge?
Screw them.
What?
Screw them.
Ladies, you're wasting time.
Fight! Get one. Mm-mm. Get one. You got one? You got one? You got one. You got one.
Gotta eat the whole thing. Tendrils and all.
Suck it in, suck it in. Like spaghetti, like spaghetti, like spaghetti. There you go.
Mrs. Eeny Meeny, open your mouth.
Show them your tongue.
Moving on.
You did it!
This is your final challenge. If you succeed, you'll be on the real Island of Doom to compete for $1 million. First, go to the cauldron. Aw, bungee cord slowing you down? Get the balloons out of your pot and shoot them in the basket behind you.
Hey, this is a bear!
Who said anything about bear, Miss Teeny Weeny? Make three baskets before the parrot nods off and become contestants on the show.
I got it, girl! I got it! I thought I got it. I can do this. I can do this. Oh, no. Oh. Okay. Here we go. I'll toss it to you. You shoot it.
Okay, good plan.
Are you ready?
Ready.
Okay.
I wasn't ready.
Are you ready now?
Yes, I'm ready now.
Okay, then catch. Oh.
desecrated the tiki.
I know, Larry. I got a better idea. You get to here, and I'll throw you the balloon.
Okay.
Come in. Get still.
Yeah.
I'm going to take this baby.
All right.
And off. You throw it to me.
All right.
Alan, pass it to Cassell and shoot.
That's one.
Good.
Where are you, Cheryl?
In the park! Get out! Got it!
That's two.
Swish.
Get it! All right, here you go. Here you go, that one. There. Okay.
Doesn't count.
Did you score? Did you score? I got another balloon. I got another balloon here. Okay, there you go.
Doesn't count.
Okay. Did we score?
One more balloon and you qualify.
Yeah, sure. All my bungees all bunched
up. I'm coming at you. Just start from there.
Parrot's getting drowsy.
The man Parrot's falling asleep.
What do you want me to do?
I want you to shoot, Cheryl.
Oh, no, I can't.
Yes, you can.
No, I'm Fancy.
Cheryl, I believe in you. Shoot.
You lost.
Well, we gave it our best shot.
Oh, Cheryl, stop it, would you? I'm not doing this kind of stuff anymore.
You know when we should stop doing this kind of stuff?
When?
When it stops being fun. Was it fun?
No.
I ate a bug.
That was fun.
Yeah, it was a blast. And as we say here on the island, get off the stage! We got people to audition.
Right. You probably got two gorgeous models coming to audition, huh?
Yeah. With gorgeous complexions, thick hair, long legs, and big bosoms.
Hello.
Hey!
What are you doing here?
Oh, we work here, Laverne.
As what?
We're in hall number two.
Don't go away. Laverne and Shirley's bloopers from the Island of Doom are coming up.
Every time it rains, pennies from heaven. Louise?
No, Laverne. Mary?
No, Maxine, but you got the first letter right.
I guess I'm psychic.
I could really use some advice from an older woman. There's this guy here that I'm crazy about.
Yeah.
He's in my history class.
Is he that blonde guy back there?
It's the guy you're with.
Okay, I can't help it. I have a lot of family. And Gary, of course, who I don't know is in the audience right over there.
Yeah.
Gary Marshall.
There's Gary.
We have Gary to thank for all this.
For everything.
Right. None of us would be here tonight were it not
That's
for Gary
right.
Marshall.
But there is one member of our family who's not with us tonight, and that's the late Phil Foster, who played my dad, Frank DeFazio, and Edna's husband.
I talked with the wheels away from the car. The car almost rolled down the hill.
I love my daddy.
Come on, don't make me
move. And my daddy loves me. He thinks I'm the greatest personality.
Now remember, we're both going to sing together. You got it? Ready.
Oh,
you doing in a Chinese restaurant in your pajamas?
Yeah, it's only 7:30.
Were you fooling around?
No, I meant it. I love you. I want to marry you. Okay?
Hey. Why him? Why did it have to be him?
I remember those words. I said them when your mother died. I said them such a long time.
It hurt.
I know. It's gonna hurt a long time. But I promise you, the hurt will go away.
I promise.
The truth.
Being part of our TV family reunion. We love sharing our memories with you, and it was great to be Laverne and Shirley again. Good night.
Good night, everybody.
Say, give me that.
You remember those girls that we saw every day?
Yeah.
What are their names again?
Water.
Only 5 days until Dinotopia, Sunday 7, 6 Central on ABC.